Today's live and uninterrupted Prime special event, coverage of the U.S. Open Cup. You get a look at El Paso, Texas, a late arriving crowd here at Socorro Stadium as we are just minutes away from the opening kickoff of today's U.S. Open Cup final. It's the Richmond Kickers and the El Paso Patriots. And we should tell you that the El Paso Patriots have brought all of their armament, all of their firepower with them. There you get a look at a Patriot missile battery. For those of you wondering, the Patriots name not after folks from the Boston Tea Party, but that very missile battery. Well, Ty Keogh, let's take a look at the starting lineup. We begin in goal with the El Paso Patriots.
Arrambide, a very classy goalkeeper coming off his line, especially Cervantes, the number 3, the most experienced player in their back line. And the goal-scoring punch coming out of the midfield, number 10, Salvador Mercado, and especially Rito Delgado, who was the second leading scorer in the U.S. ISL professional division.
And let's take a look at the Richmond Kickers all the way from Richmond, Virginia.
And Virginia is definitely the way to look at it. This is Arrambide, the goalkeeper for the El Paso Patriots. We talk about the Richmond Kickers, 10 of these players former NCAA All-Americans, many of them having played for the University of Virginia. We have a look at their lineup. O'Carroll in goal. Clark will be marking Rito Delgado. That's a really important matchup. And another key being Ben Crawley, very devastating out of midfield, getting forward to score goals. And Kamler and Ucrop, a very potent scoring duo up top.
On the one side, we have the Richmond Kickers coming in with a continental style of play, mixing up both the long and short ball. On the other side, we have the El Paso Patriots, definitely in Latin style of play. In terms of team makeups, contrast there as well. The Richmond Kickers, nearly a 100% U.S.-born starting lineup. The El Paso Patriots, a mixture of both American and Mexican-born players. Kevin, this game today, the face of U.S. soccer in the 1990s.
In England, you have the FA Cup. In America, we have the U.S. Open Cup. For the Richmond Kickers and the El Paso Patriots, it's coming up. There you get a look at Arturo Angeles, FIFA referee. We got the A team out here today. And we're just about set to go. The Patriots moving from left to right, and they'll be kicking the ball off, and here we go. Rejected there, and El Paso just trying to take the pressure off, clears it into open space. Now David Stewart has one man to beat. Stewart breaks free. Stewart, the shot. He fired it wide. And he had Causey out of his goal.
Somehow, he makes his way through two Richmond defenders, splits them, is all the way through on the left foot. Causey comes to cut the angle, and it looks like he just sliced it.
Now the return pass. Kalishaw is open. Doesn't have numbers. Oh, nice move. Beating out in front. Campbell, the shot, the goal!
Here. This ball looked like it may have been out. Watch this. He pulls it back in at the last second and then is able to slot the ball out in front. It's hit on the second touch. Rob Ucrop.
I think we can safely say the momentum of this game seems to be changing.
Absolutely. The crowd now on their feet, really into this game, cheering their home team to try and tie it.
That is loose. Far side, O'Haver, hit a shot block. Opportunity, but a sliding block.
Nothing O'Haver could do, really, as Causey played it perfectly, coming out to block the shot by cutting the angle. Look at the scramble here in the Richmond penalty area. This ball pops in O'Haver, but Causey's right there, smothering it as O'Haver shoots it.
Now a numbers advantage for Richmond. They got Williams on the right side, Ucrop on the right side. Here's Ucrop, the shot blocked. Arrambide comes out to get it, can't control it. Ucrop in the corner. David Bolton on the sideline. David?
Yeah, thanks, Kevin, very much. One man very nervous at this point. That's the coach of the El Paso Patriots, Oscar Lara, coming in. Several people here in El Paso not too happy. The team has won division titles the last 2 years, but have lost in the playoffs. Some speculation this may be his last game with his team trailing right now. I don't know how things look, but I can tell you one thing. Here in the second half, there's a lot more space between him and Enrique Cervantes, the El Paso owner, sitting alongside him on the bench.
That's called a hot seat down there on the bench. Oscar Lira, the coach, with the cap on, the owner in the white shirt next to him, Enrique Cervantes. They've had a great deal of success here in El Paso. They draw very good crowds. They haven't won the big games.
David Stewart out in front, the shot blocked!
Richmond been able to save the ball off the goal line when Causey was beaten. First, it was Richie Williams, this time at the other side. Again, the corner by Stewart is driven all the way to the back post and hammered down. And there's the goal line save.
Mercado towards the area, ball cleared. David Stewart is there. Stewart, nice move around Kalashaw. Now Stewart going one-on-one. They play it back. Long drive.
Delgado deflected the long-range shot, leaving no chance for Jeff Causey. And this stadium is electrified by the comeback goal. This is Sal Mercado, wisely dishes the ball off, and it's a great low-driven shot. We're going to look at the tying goal for the El Paso Patriots. This is Sal Mercado, wisely takes his time, dishes the ball across beautifully to Amparo, and then it goes off the foot.
Mike Crawley plays it wide, far side. Richie Williams centers it in front, knocked down Arrambide. The shot in front, Arrambide, another save. Arrambide clears.
A huge save by Arrambide. Jake Arrambide holding his ground there, not committing. Making the most important save he's definitely so far made in this game. There he is, he punches that one down and really should have punched it away. This ball driven down low, but Arrambide is showing great agility and flexibility.
Down with an open net. Gomez crosses the header and Causey the save.
Coming for El Paso, Stewart, a great outswinger. Causey's out, he doesn't get to it, he's out of position now. And Causey had to make the big save to secure the tie.
Ucrop, he scores! Ucrop makes it 1-0.
Ucrop, the MVP of the USISL Premier League, their amateur division, puts it well out of the reach of Jake Arrambide. I'm going to stick my neck out just a bit here. Sal Mercado, a very experienced Mexican professional player, about to take the shot against Jeff Causey, but I'm going to lean towards the bigger range that Jeff Causey has in covering this goal and making more stops than Arrambide.
Mercado, the shot, he scores, and it's 1-1.
Very cool is Sal Mercado. Mercado leans one way, tucks it the other way.
Ryan Bates scores. Gomez, the shot, the save by Causey. Ben Crawley on the penalty kick. Here we go. And he scores. And it's 3-2.
That was Gabino Amparán, who scored the tying goal in regulation, the number four. Very dangerous player coming forward this time. Shows his cool and calm collectedness. Look at this ball. Unstoppable, even had Causey guessed correctly.
It is 3-2. Jake Arrambide, his feet on the line. And the save by Arrambide. It is still 3-2. The shot, the save by Causey. That time, Cesar Sosa denied.
Superman ran into some kryptonite. Couldn't get it past Jeff Causey. The right-footed shot, he tries to side-foot it. Causey read it the whole way, guessed correctly.
Michael Brady, a second-half substitute, can put it away here.
If he scores it, it's over.
The shot, he scores! The Richmond Kickers have done it in penalty kicks.
Even though El Paso loses on penalty kicks, they should hold their heads up and know that they've had a great season and lost in a difficult fashion by way of the penalty kick. Two saves by Jeff Causey, wins it in penalty kicks for the Richmond Kickers, an amateur team taking the U.S. Open Cup.